You said where I've been. Everybody asks where I've been. I've been around. I've been out here. But see, the thing is, when you don't have those records on the radio spinning constantly, mm-hmm. when you don't have the videos spinning constantly, people seem to think you fell off, you dead and all that. But really, man, I'm just independent. I'm just more independent right now. And I've been around. I've been out here.
What up, guys? Your boy Quake, and I'm back with a new episode of What Happened To. The first episode was, of course, Chameleonaire, and I got some amazing feedback on that. So I'm going to continue this series, and I got a bunch of artists that I'm going to be focusing on in the near future. There's one thing, however, that I want to clarify that I didn't on the last episode, or at least the first episode of the series, and that's me stating that Chameleonaire was a one-hit wonder. What I mean by one-hit wonder is an artist that does not have another song on the top 10 Hot 100. Chameleonaire only had Ridin' as a top 10 single, actually landed at number 1 on the Hot 100, and nothing after that. So that's what I mean by one-hit wonder. I don't mean that the artist is garbage and that they can't deliver any more hits or anything like that. It's just the fact that the artist did not have a top 10 hit after that at all. That's a one-hit wonder to me. And if you go on Billboard.com, search up Chameleonaire, click on his name, you'll see that Ridin' is the only top 10 hit he had. He had a song with Ciara, but that's Ciara's song, and I don't really count that. So that's what I mean by one-hit wonder, the artist that did not have another top 10 hit. Now that that's clarified, this artist I'm going to be talking about is definitely not a one-hit wonder. This guy had hit after hit in his prime, and as you can tell by the video title, I'm talking about Chingy. I know you popular, but you gon' be famous today. I say I like the way you do that right there, right there.
What you doing?
I'm chilling at the Holiday Inn.
Who you with?
Me and my people, won't you drink over your friends?
Who?
If you thought you would come go with me,
me.
If you was my baby, if you thought you would come go with me,
me.
If you was my lady.
And Chingy is straight out of St. Louis, Missouri. He blew up around the same time that Nelly did, so it was definitely a good look for St. Louis when it comes to hip-hop. He started making music in his early teens, and he got it with a St. Louis group called Without Warning, and they released a song called What's Poppin' Off, and that became a local hit, which then garnered the attention of Nelly and Ludacris, and Nelly decided to bring him out as an opening act for his 2002 tour. And then, this is when he really blew up. In May 10th, 2003, he dropped his single Right There while he was signed to Ludacris' Disturbing the Peace label. And because of the major success of Right There, the label decided that he can release his debut album Jackpot, which dropped 2 months later on July 15th, 2003 on Ludacris' label. And this album spawned two more hits, Holiday Inn with Snoop Dogg and Ludacris, and One Call Away featuring Jay Weave. Right There peaked at number 2 on the Billboard Hot 100 on August 9, 2003. One Call Away peaked at number 2 on the Hot 100 on March 13, 2004. And Holiday Inn peaked at number 3 on the Hot 100 on November 8, 2003. So it's clear that he had three major hits, both in the top 3. None of them got number 1, unfortunately, but these were top 3 hits, and that's insane. A lot of artists do not get that on their first album. It's rare that that ever happens. And since he spawned those hits, his debut album, Jackpot, ended up selling 2 million copies worldwide. So, of course, he had to follow up with his second studio album, and this is where a lot of artists do not follow up because their first album is so big that they just can't match the success. But luckily for Chingy, he didn't match the first album success, but he did release a few hits. The first one was Balla Baby, which was released on November 1st, 2004. The song did not get in the top 10 on the Hot 100, but it did reach number 20 on the Hot 100, which is good enough to keep you afloat in the mainstream light. Another song that he had that he was featured on that kept him afloat in the mainstream light was Houston's song, I Like That, featuring Chingy, Nate Dogg, and I-20. This song ended up peaking at number 11 on the Billboard Hot 100, and Chingy killed that song, so it kept him afloat. And his second album, Powerballin', did end up ultimately selling 1 million copies, so it was still a good look, but this is where his downfall slowly started coming, at least that's what a lot of people thought. On September 19th, 2006, he released his third studio album, Hoodstar, and it featured the hit single, Pulling Me Back, featuring Tyrese.
It was meant to be, you were meant for me, so that means we gotta make
This song ended up charting at number 9 on October 7, 2006, so he was back in the top 10 for the Hot 100, so it seemed like he got his fame back, his success back, and a lot of people weren't calling him a one-hit wonder anymore at this time. The album ended up going gold, so selling around 500,000 copies. So it did not match his first album or his second album, but it did well enough to be considered a success because in 2006 is when albums started selling a lot less than they used to. And this is also when the label situation with Chingy was getting bad. He decided to leave Capitol Records, which was under a distribution deal with Disturbing the Peace. He left them because he felt like, because of the poor performance of Hoodstar, that Capitol did not know how to market him. So he decided to go with Disturbing the Peace over at Def Jam. And this really didn't do much. He released his fourth studio album on December 18, 2007 called Hate or Love It. The album did terrible. None of the singles really charted. The only single that charted was Fly Like Me. It landed a number 89 on the Billboard Hot 100. So that's a terrible number, not even in the top 40. The album ended up selling 30,000 copies within the first week, and I'm sure it sold about probably 100,000 total. So that's terrible from his first album to now, completely declined. And this is where the label sort of dropped him. He didn't really get the promotion he felt like he wanted. What he states is that he wanted to be on the same level as Ludacris. He wanted to be promoted as a Ludacris because Ludacris was, that's his label, Disturbing the Peace. He was promoted a lot more. He felt like he should be on an even playing field because he's proven himself over time. And I agree with that. He's proven himself. He's gotten hits. So why not push, you know, his music more and more?
You know, coming back at me, it wasn't properly set up to me when I came back to Disturbing the Peace. When you come back to a situation like that and you got a big artist like Ludacris and an artist of my stature coming back to that label, it supposed to have been set up where me and it supposed to have been presented by me and Chris. You supposed to got magazine covers, been on talk shows. It supposed to just been presented in a packaged right way, and it wasn't at all. It was just kind of like, okay, Chingy's here, but all right, so okay.
So because of that frustration, he decided to go independently. He left Disturbing the Peace and decided to pursue his music with no label backing him. He released an insane amount of mixtapes following this. He even had a mixtape called Jackpot Back, hopefully trying to regain his fans from his first album, although it didn't go too well. Some of the songs that he released, I really ended up liking, surprisingly. There's one song called I'm Her, which is a spinoff of Right There, but it's not the same exact song. It's the topic on I'm Her is way different from Right There. That's a song that you guys should check out. It's one of my favorites. It's also a song that I feel like would have blown up if he had a major label push with that single. He also decided to get a degree in astrology. That's something that he's really passionate about, so he decided to go to college, get a degree in that, instead of just focusing on music and hoping that that will pop off. He's also doing a lot of worldwide touring because a lot of people don't realize an artist who has a lot of hits can still tour. He can still make money off those hits because there are a lot of people that want to listen to those songs live that never got a chance to. So he's still touring worldwide, doing shows. I'm sure getting some good money from that as well as royalties because a lot of his songs have been featured in movies and TV shows and stuff like that. So he's getting money from those hits. That's what a lot of people don't realize. If you have a major, major amount of hits in your career, you can still get a lot of money from it.
The show was good. The shows overseas are always great. You know, the people over there, for some reason, it just seems like it means a lot to them.
They embrace you more,
take more to it. And they can't speak one lick of English in the crowd, but know all the words to the song.
One thing that Chingy maintains that ruined his career was that transsexual rumors, the rumors that he dated a transsexual by the name of Cindy Starr. Those rumors were completely false. Even the transsexual woman decided to say that, hey, I was lying, this was just for attention. So that, he maintains, did not let him get a new record deal because it tarnished his brand and his name.
It actually, it injured my career a little bit. I watched it happen. I lost a deal because of that.
You lost a deal over this?
Yeah, I lost a deal because of that. A record situation. I lost a deal because of that.
Well, how did you know that it was over that?
Because it was said to me. Because there was so much bad publicity around that.
That's what he says, but we don't know 100%. It might just be because the music isn't as good as it once was. I mean, you can look up a lot of songs from Chingy. He's constantly releasing new music, and it just simply doesn't hit like it once was. And he's trying to follow this mainstream sound that's going on in 2017 in hip-hop with trap music, and it's just not working for him that well. So with that being said, he's still making music, he's still touring, he has a degree in astrology, so he's doing well for himself, and he might not ever be the artist that he once was in 2003, but he had a hell of a career. A lot of artists only have one hit and just completely disappear. At least he had a few hits. At least he's still touring from them and he's making money from them. So he's doing well for himself. So with that being said, leave a comment below. Let me know what you guys think. Do you guys think Chingy will ever make a comeback? It's hip hop. You never know in hip hop. It's possible. Do you guys think that? Leave a comment below. Like, share, and definitely subscribe. I do videos like this daily on hip hop news, who changed the music industry, hip hop beef, and much, much more. So definitely subscribe. Follow me on Twitter and on Instagram at QuakeGW. Like us on Facebook, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.